Today again, we shall discuss about 10 most important questions for coming JEE Main exam. Now the first question, 1.82 gram of a metal requires 32.5 ml of 1 normal HCl to dissolve it. What is the equivalent weight of the metal? So you have to find out the equivalent weight. Now we know that if or whenever a chemical reaction takes place, then we can find out the equivalent weight of a particular substance. Here the metal reacts with HCl to liberate hydrogen to dissolve the metal. So a reaction takes place, that's why we can calculate the equivalent weight of that substance. Now we know that 1000 ml of one normal substance is equal to 1 gram equivalent weight of that substance. Now 1000 ml 1 normal HCl, now we know that 32.5 ml of 1 normal HCl dissolves, which is equivalent to 32.5 normal 5 ml 1 normal of metal. So 32.5 ml 1 normal of metal contains 1.82 gram of metal, because we know that 32.5 ml of 1 normal HCl dissolves only 1.82 gram of metal. Therefore we can write that 32.5 ml 1 normal metal is equals to 1.82 gram. Therefore 1000 ml 1 normal metal, because we know that 1000 ml 1 normal is the equivalent weight, gram equivalent weight of that substance. So this equal to 1.82 by 32.5 into 1000. That means 1820 by 32.5. So near about this equal to 56 gram. Therefore the equivalent weight is 56. Equivalent weight of the metal is equal to 56. This is the answer. This is the equivalent weight of the metal. Question number 2. Calculate the frequency of spectral line emitted the electron in n equal to 3. That means when the electron is in n equal to 3, jumps to hydrogen atom, declines to ground state. So the hydrogen already present in the hydrogen atom, the electron already present in the hydrogen atom in n equal to 3. It declines to the ground state. So you have to find out the frequency of that spectral line given that Rydberg constant of hydrogen 1.09 10 to the power 5 centimeter second. Therefore, we know that according to Rydberg equation, 1 by lambda equal to Rydberg constant into z square 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square, where n1 initial orbit and n2 is the final orbit. Therefore, nu equal to, we know that nu equal to c by lambda, that means c into 1 by lambda, that means c into Rydberg constant of hydrogen into z square. For hydrogen, you know that this is 1 square, 1 by n1 square, because this was first in the ground state, n1 is the ground state final, and n2 from where it jumps, that means n2 is the third orbit, so this will be 3 square, 1 square minus 3 square, and we know that the value of c is equal to 3 into 10 to the power 10 centimeter per second, because Rydberg constant is given in CGS unit, 3 into 10 to the power 10. Rydberg constant is given 1.09 10 to the power 5 into 1 into 1 by 1 square means 1 minus 1 by 9, that means 8 by 9. So this will be equal to 3 when multiplied by 1.09, that means 3.27 into 8 by 9 into 10 to the power 15. This, so approx equal to, this will be cancelled by 1.09. 3 when divided by 1.09, 0.36, near about 0.36 into 8 into 10 to the power 15. This is approx equal to 2.9 into 10 to the power 15. This is the frequency, that means this hertz is the frequency of the spectral line emitted in their particular case. Question number 3. Write the correct relation of P1, P2 and P3 in the following graph. This is the graph G versus T. T is on the x-axis and G is on the y-axis. P1, P2 and P3 you have to draw the P1, P2, P3. But you have to find out the correct relation. First, at constant temperature, if we draw the perpendicular on the pressure axis, that means this. So, and draw the perpendicular on the volume axis. So, from P1, draw the perpendicular. This is, suppose, A point, draw this. From B point, we can draw this. From C point, we can draw this. Now, this is V1, this is V2, this is V3. Now we know that at constant temperature, V is proportional to 1 by P when T is constant. Therefore, higher the value of V, lower will be the pressure. And hence, the order of the pressure is P3 is the highest. And that is greater than P2, greater than P1. This is the actual order of the pressure in the given graph. When, question number 4, when sulfur is in the form I said, is heated at 900 Kelvin, the initial pressure of 1 atmosphere falls by 30% at equilibrium because conversion of S8 to S2. Now we have to calculate the value of K equilibrium. We know that S8, when it converts to S2 by heating, S8 converts to S2, that means 4 moles of S2 will be obtained from 1 mole of S8. Let 1 atmosphere was the initial pressure when T equal to T. When T equal to T, 1 atmosphere was the initial pressure, it will be 0. But when T equal to T equilibrium, then 1 minus 30% of the initial pressure gets false. That means 30% means 0.3. So this will be the atmospheric pressure, and that will be 4 into 0.3 because the number of moles increases and pressure hence increases. So it becomes 1.2 atmosphere, and this becomes 0.7 atmosphere. Therefore, K equilibrium, we know that product S2 to the power 4 divided by reactant S8. That means 1.2 to the power 4 divided by 0.7 atmosphere to the power 4 by atmosphere means atmosphere cube. So this will be equal to 1.44 into 1.2 means 1.768 into 1.2 divided by 0.7 atmosphere cube. That means near about, when this will be cancelled, near about 25. So approx 3 atmosphere cube, approx 3 atmosphere cube, this will be the value, near about 2.9. So this is the value of the K equilibrium. Question number 5. What is the pH of the solution which have 0.1 molar ammonia and 0.05 molar ammonium chloride, given that Kb of ammonia is equal to 10 to the power minus 5. Now we know that according to Henderson equation, we can calculate for this basic buffer, it is a basic buffer solution, POH equal to PKB plus log of concentration of salt by concentration of base. Now we have to calculate the value of PKB. KB is given 10 to the minus 5, so PKB equal to minus log of 10 to the power minus 5, that means 5. So in case of PKB, we can write value 5 plus log of salt. Concentration of salt is 0.05 because this is the concentration of the ammonium chloride, 0.05 molar. And that of base, 0.1 molar. So this will be 5 plus cancel half, that means log half. So this will be 5 minus log 2, and we can calculate the value of log 2, 0.303, so minus 0.303, that means approx equal to 4.7. so POH equal to 4.7 POH. Therefore pH, we have to calculate the pH of the solution. pH equal to, you know that pH plus POH equal to 14 at 298 Kelvin. So pH equal to 14 minus 4.7, that means 9.3. so this is the pH of the solution. Question number 6. This is the compound here. This is the chiral center, CH2CH3. This is CH3. This is OH, alcoholic group. This is hydrogen below the plane. Above the plane, alcoholic group. It is treated with SOCl2. The product is given instead of OH. Here it is Cl. So, what is the mechanism of the reaction first? And R, the final configuration will be of the product will be R, S, R and S both, or produces a chiral center. Produces an chiral center, it is, we have seen that this compound is also a chiral center, it contains a chiral center, that means this carbon is attached to its CH2CH3 ethyl group, methyl group, chloride, and this is hydrogen actually, so it also contains a chiral center, so option number 4 is already cancelled. Now, we have to draw the mechanism at first. See that OH is substituted by the chlorine, but the configuration is retained. So, retention of configuration is occur. Retention of configuration is occurred. Or configuration is occurred. And in this case, we know that substitution nucleophilic, because Cl minus is a nucleophile, SN type reaction may take place in both the types SN1 as well as SN2. In case of SN2, inversion of configuration occurs. In case of SN2, because the chloride minus, that means the nucleophile approaches from the back side of the chiral center. But here the retention of configuration occurs, that's why it goes through SN1 mechanism through the formation of a carbocation. So this is the mechanism SN1. Now we know that in case of SN1, retention of configuration occurs, that means it goes through the carbocation. The first carbocation is this. This is the carbocation. Actually it contains this. This is the carbocation. Then it is sp2 hybridized. So Cl minus may attack from both sides, either from below of the plane and or above the plane. So it produces both the compounds R and S. Actually the mixture of these two compounds produces a racemic mixture. R and S produces a racemic mixture. So this is the answer, actually option number C, R and S both, and this is the SN1 mechanism. Question number 7. This is a phenyl benzyl ether. This ether is treated with HI. The products are P and Q. We have to identify the products P and Q. Now, if we show the mechanism, this is phenyl ether, this is benzyl group. So, if or whenever it is treated with HI, HI dissociates to form H plus and I minus, and H plus gets protonated through the lone pair of the oxygen. It forms PH, single bond O, H, this will be plus. Pengene ring. Now, I minus may attach to this center, may attach to this center, or may attach to this center. But these two centers, neutrophilic substitution reaction doesn't take place because these centers are attached directly with the pengene ring and no substitution there takes place with the nucleophile because it is electron rich center, sp2 hybridized carbon through resonance. The double bond character introduced, so these two cannot take place substitution, rather it takes place at this part. So the bond dissociates from this linkage, it produces PH, single bond OH plus, I minus attacks to this center, so iodine, this bond actually CH2, it actually dissociates from this linkage, so it forms CH2, iodine CH2, single bond benzene ring. So these will be the products. This is P, phenol, this is Q, benzyl iodide. So P is phenol and Q is benzyl iodide. Question number 8. What is the relation between the following compounds? There are three compounds, A, B and C. These are the structures of three compounds. Examine these structures and which of the following four is the actual relation between A, B and C? B and C are resonating structures. A and B are resonating structures, A and B are tautomers, A and C are tautomers. Now, what is the basic difference between a resonating structure and a tautomer? We know that in resonating structures, no atom transfer is possible, but tautomer, hydrogen transfer is applicable, is permissible actually. So, B and C, first option is B and C are resonating structures. B and C are resonating structures. Here, hydrogen is vanished. In C, hydrogen is vanished. No atom transfer is possible in case of resonance. So B and C are resonating structure. It is the wrong and dissipation. A and B are regulating structures. A and B. A contains hydrogen with the nitrogen atom, but B has no hydrogen with the nitrogen atom. So atom transfer is permissible here, is allowed. But you know that in case of regulating structures, atom transfer is not permissible. So B is not the answer. Actually, 2 is not also the answer. A and B are tautomers. See that A and B are tautomers. Why? We know that X double bond Y, single bond Z, single bond hydrogen. If it is the structure of a compound in tautomeric form, it converts to this. In its tautomeric form, it converts to this. Hydrogen goes to that, single bond Y, double bond Z. And here also, see that X double bond Y, single bond Z, single bond hydrogen. And it, when tautomerizes, it forms this structure. So A and B are tautomer. This is the actual right option. A and C are tautomer. A and C cannot be tautomer because atom already bond dissociates. So atom transfer is not permissible here. In case of tautomer, hydrogen must be shifted. Here hydrogen cannot be shifted in A and C. So this is our wrong answer. Actual answer is 3. A and B are tautomers. Question number 9. If equal volume of barium chloride and sodium fluoride solutions are mixed, which of these combinations doesn't give PPT? Given that Ksp of barium fluoride is given 1.7 10 to the minus 7. Concentration of barium chloride, concentration of sodium fluoride. So we have to find out actually the reaction between barium chloride BaCl2 and sodium fluoride NaF to form BaF2 plus NaCl. Now molarity is given. So you have to find out the KIP here, potash KIP ionic product. If or whenever KIP is greater than KSP, precipitation occurs, otherwise no precipitation occurs. Now in case of, we have to find out the concentration of barium 2 plus and concentration of F minus, because in BaF2, in case of BaF2, the KSP value, we can calculate either KSP or KIP first. Concentration of Ba2 plus in case of this and F minus square. So, concentration of Ba2 plus is 10 to the minus 3. F minus square is 2 into 10 to the minus 2. That means 10 to the power minus 3 into 2 into 10 to the power minus 2 square. That means 4 10 to the minus 7. 4 into 10 to the power minus 7, which is greater than KSP. So precipitation occurs. This is not the answer, because the question is needed in which combination doesn't give precipitate. So this is not the answer. Here precipitation occurs. 10 to the power minus 3, 1.5 into 10 to the power minus 2 square. That means 2.25 into minus 7, 10 to the power minus 7, which is also greater than KSP. So precipitation occurs. KIP is greater than KSP. Precipitation occurs. This is also not the answer. Question number 3. 1.5, 10 to the power minus 2. This is the concentration of barium 2 plus and fluoride is 10 to the power minus 3. 10 to the power minus 3 square. That means 1.5 into 10 to the power minus 8, which is less than KSP. So no precipitation occurred. This is the actual answer, option number C. And now question number 4, 2 into 10 to the minus 2, you have to calculate 2 into 10 to the power minus 2 into 2 into 10 to the power minus 2 square. That means 4 into 2, 8 into 10 to the power minus 6, which is also greater than KSP. Therefore, precipitation occurred. So in only case of question number 3, option number 3, no precipitation occurs. Question number 10. This is the last question. Benzoic acid, PaCOH plus CH3OH, oxygen is leveling with 18 isotope, in presence of acid catalyst produces X plus H2O. What is the X here? We know that this is an acid plus alcohol reaction. So it's esterification process. The name of the reaction is esterification here. This is esterification. Now esterification in case of acid. Now, how the mechanism proceeds? PaHC double bond OOH. First, it gets protonated in presence of H plus to form this cation, oxonium cation. Now, it withdraws it withdraws towards it and hence makes this carbon more electron deficient, and hence CH3OH oxygen is leveling with 18 isotope. Lone pair attack this center and bond dissociates to form pH. C double bond O, single bond O, which is labeling with 18 and is positively charged because it donates its lone pair, hydrogen CH3. Now, to increase the electron density over the oxygen, it releases H plus readily in the acidic medium. So, it releases H plus and the final product will be pH, C double bond O, O, labeling with 18 CH3, methyl benzoate. This is the ester containing the isotope 18 attached with the PHCO group.